Good evening and welcome to our district jazz night. It was nice to be here. I want to start out by saying thank you for live streaming this year, all year actually, just being able to live stream all our concerts. I really appreciate it. That being said, hello and shout out to everybody that's behind the TV screen right there. We open up with our first piece, Just Wait Till Friday. Solos by Levi Brown on trumpet, Matthew Drendel on trumpet, Oliver Armstrong on alto, and Grant Hebert on tenor.
Thank you.
opens up with a trumpet solo by Matthew Drendel on Open Arms.
Thank you.
for being ready to do that. I was so shocked, so I couldn't have done that, but good job for you. It sounds great. Our next piece is a Herbie Hancock arrangement, or written by Herbie Hancock, arranged by Mike Come Up. This is Cantaloupe Island. Thank you. One of my favorite parts of tonight is playing a combined piece with the middle school jazz band and high school jazz band. So if you give us just a second, we're going to bring the high school jazz band out here and play a combined piece for you. Just a second.
I think we're ready. So, on stage are the folks that arrived the earliest out of any other students at Hawkinson Middle or High School. And thank you to the parents out there that get them there or wake them up or whatever you've got to do to get in there. We got together real quick this morning and rehearsed this piece together, and so we'll see how that goes. It's gonna be great. And I know that sounds sarcastic, but I'm not being sarcastic. It's gonna be great. We are going to do a piece by the great Gordon Goodwin, arranged by Mike Lewis. This is The Jazz Police. We hope you enjoy the combined Hawkinson Middle and High School jazz band.
Thank you.
give us a second to do one more set change here, and then we'll be back with the high school jazz bands. Started. First of all, I want to say, traditionally in this concert, we are followed up. Our closing act for the evening is the Clark College Jazz Band. We were really excited to get them out here, but unfortunately, as many of you know, we're not quite out of this pandemic yet, and they had a few COVID cases that prevented them from coming out tonight. So we're sorry they're not here, but we'll catch them next year. I do know that Dr. Harris is somewhere out in the audience. So there he is up in the back there. So thanks for coming and supporting us. He's good, everyone. He's good. So we look forward to reestablishing that tradition next year. But you're still in for a treat because you've still got the award-winning Hawkinson High School Jazz Band. For a lot of them, this is their final concert. We've got four members of the class of 2022. I'll tell you a little bit about them a little bit later, but I let them basically choose all four tunes that we're doing on this concert. So this is kind of like what they wanted to do to end up their career here. And so we are going to start things off with a pretty ambitious tune. that they wanted to do. This is by the great Thad Jones, Mel Lewis, big band, Groove Merchants. It's got a pretty kicking sax solo in the middle of it. You're also gonna hear solos from Adam Honreiter on guitar and Kaisho Barnhill on piano. So we hope you enjoy our opening tune, The Groove Merchant.
Thank you.
and now another hand for our soloist, Adam Honreiter, Kaisha Barhill, and our saxophone section. All right. It wouldn't be a concert that I program without some Count Basie music by the great Sammy Nestico. We are going to next do an old classic, The Queen Bee, which is right out of the Count Basie book. You're going to hear solos. Let's see, you're going to hear Kaisha one more time on piano, and Parker as well, Parker Bruni on tenor saxophone. This is The Queen Bee. Thank you. our daily helping of cheese. So this is, I need a look. Sorry, that was bad. This next tune is just a fun, goofy piece where basically I think the premise of this is somebody decided, what happened if Beethoven could swing? And this is entitled Blues for Elise. And it is, you'll recognize the tune. It's just done in a jazz waltz way, and it's just a fun tune. And you're going to hear, I think we're going to hear from Parker one more time on tenor sax, and I think we're going to hear from Kaisho again on piano. So, you know, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Here it is, Blues for Elise. Middle School Jazz Band. Don't forget, almost every single one of them started out right where you are. So we want to see you as soon as you get up here as freshmen. Eighth graders, jazz band auditions are due at the end of next week. You got the information. If you didn't come and see me, we want you to join us. So, because you deserve to be here. I also want to say thanks to TJ Bruning running the sound down here. I want to purposefully didn't ask him to run sound because it's his son's senior concert. Like, I was just going to do it, and Rittenberg was going to do it. And I came out here ready to go, and he's sitting there. I was like, I'm not going to mess with it. So he just, you know, it's like, we're right here. Good job, man. So thanks, TJ. He's run all of our sound for all of our concerts this year, and I really appreciate it. Also want to just acknowledge all the work that this band has done. It's been a, hasn't been a completely normal year, but we've got back to some things. We were able to do three jazz festivals this year, and that was Skyview, the Clackamas College Jazz Festival, and this Columbia Basin College Band Festival out in Pasco, and they took first place at all three of them in their division. Can I get my class of 2022 folks to come and stand right up here? So we have four graduating seniors this year. Come on up, come on up. What's amazing is, I was talking with Parker about this a couple of weeks ago. A couple of them have been in the band. How many of you have been in the band all 4 years, the jazz band all 4 years? Okay, right? These guys have never experienced not taking first place. It's kind of crazy. So, a testament to their hard work, their leadership within the band, so I did just want to acknowledge really quick our seniors. First of all, closest to me on the piano is Kaisho Barnhill. Kaisho has been a student in that band, right? So Kaisho joined in that infamous 1920 school year. And he just, you can see, he just slides right in. He's one of these great students where he does amazing work and I do very little, but I get to take the credit for it. It's great. I love students like that. But he is a freak in the best sense of the word. And he's going to be continuing his musical journey. Something bit him, and he's going to be going into music education to become a band director. Look at him here, right? Look at this. This is like you in like 15 years. Yeah, I know. Check this out. Check out the shiny up here. Yeah, okay. So Kaisho, fantastic, a leader of our drum line as well, and has just been a phenomenal player. And can't thank you enough for your work. Next to him is Parker Bruning on tenor sax. Parker is one of the few folks that has been in jazz band and in wind ensemble all 4 years that he's been in the band program. I can remember very distinctly at this concert watching Parker perform in the middle school jazz band and being like, yeah, that one's mine. Yeah, let's get him up here. And so he's been a fantastic talent and a fantastic leader throughout his time here, whether he's in this band. You know, give him a soprano, tell him to play soprano. Yep, got that. Give him a flute. Yeah, sure, why not? Play the flute. Alto saxophone, it doesn't matter. He does great work. He's going to be continuing on with music as well at Clark College, so Dr. Harris talked with him. We can't thank you enough for everything that you've done, Parker. You've been great. So. Next to him is Owen Teckenberg, our lead alto player. Owen, have you been in the band 3 years? Okay, yes. So he joined his sophomore year as well and has been a great lead alto player. I'll get to Ethan as well, but this whole saxophone section has been, you can see they've kind of grown up together in this and have done some really great work. But Owen, as leader of the section, has really done a great job motivating and keeping people you know, in check. He's a great player as well. You're going to hear him soloing on this last tune that we're going to do. But Owen, can't thank you enough for all of your hard work, so thank you. And then rounding out the bottom of our band over here, in the best sense of the word, is Ethan Hsu on barry saxophone. because it's quite literally one of the loudest people I've ever met, and that whether it's on the instrument or just vocally, it's great. But he's obviously there's never a dull moment when Ethan is around, and he's a great player too. Again, he's one of those that I can just put things in front of him and know that it's gonna sound great no matter what context we're in, no matter what band we're in. Hold down the bottom over there. He's also a great example of how you can make band work in terms of whatever you want to do up here. Because in addition to being a fantastic musician, he's also a fantastic wrestler, making it way, way, way on in the postseason. Great in cross country. He's done track. I mean, all this kind of stuff. So Ethan is an example. So don't let anybody tell you it can't be done. It can be done. He's look at that. That's what you can be right there. Ethan Chu. All right, so here at Hawkinson High School, I award each year to a graduating senior the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award. This is a nationally recognized award where band directors get to give it to one person. I wish I could give it to more than one person, but it can only go to one person. As you just heard, all of these folks are very deserving of this award, but again, there can only be one. This person gets this cool trophy and a certificate that I forgot in my office, and their name goes on a plaque in the band room that is ongoing. It goes all the way back right now to when we started it in 2008 or 2009, I think, so there's gonna be a few names up there, so people will remember you forever. So this year's Louis Armstrong Jazz Award for the class of 2022 goes to Parker Bruning. This gooey show of emotion. We are going to close things out tonight. This is our last tune of the evening, last tune of the 2022 school year. This is a folk tune, and again, this is what they wanted to close out with, and it's a fun toe-tapping tune. Like I said, you're going to hear a solo from Owen Teckenberg on alto. I also want to acknowledge Ethan Shue on Barry Saxman as well, because as you'll see, while he doesn't get exactly a featured solo, it ain't funk without the Barry saxophone. So here we go with a tune by Jeff Jarvis. This is Critical Mass. We'll be right back. going to do it for us. Hope to see you on Saturday for the Fun Days Parade, the Starlight Parade, next Tuesday for our District Band Festival. Maybe I'll see you at graduation, and then after that, we'll sleep. How about that? Happy good night, everybody. Thank you.